Okay, so we are over here at Namecheap, and if you are someone who is brand new to building websites, or if this is your first affiliate website that you are building, you'll definitely want to be paying attention step by step through this video because it is very, very important. The way I go about setting up my websites is a bit different than most. Most will go over to the hosting company, such as HostGator or Bluehost or GoDaddy or wherever, and they'll set up the domain and the hosting with them, and that's perfectly fine. But I like to have all of my sites separate, so that way if something were to change or something happens with the host, I can just switch over name servers, switch over hosting to another hosting company. And having your domains essentially stored elsewhere is something that makes that very, very easy. And it'll make things a bit easier when we start doing SEO and having to get PBNs and all that sort of stuff, because when you have multiple sites, you do not want it to have the same name server or anything like that. So we'll be employing Cloudflare, which is 100% free service, but basically that will make things look a lot more natural to Google. More on that will be coming later. And when it comes to the actual domain name of your site, there are a few guidelines that you absolutely have to abide by. Number one, this is probably the most important thing. Do not make it someone's name and construction, for example, like Mark Johnson Construction, Mark Johnson Water Restoration, because when someone goes to the website and then they call the phone number, they are not going to be getting in touch with Mark Johnson Water Damage Restoration. And that's just not ethical and plain not cool. It's also a great way to ruin the relationship that you have with your affiliate network. You do not want to do that. You want to be on good terms with your affiliate network at all times and be abiding by their rules that they have for generating traffic to the offers. So the best way to go about it is to do something relatively broad, but also niche specific. So for example, we have North Texas Water Damage Restoration. That is the case study site here for the course. You could also do something such as National Fire Damage Repair 24/7 if you want to throw that in. Usually a lot of brands within the restoration niche will have 24/7 in their name because it tells the customer that, hey, we're open 24/7, we're here to help when you need it. And that's definitely something I would recommend putting on your domain if you so choose. So next, what we're going to do is go over here and click search, and we're gonna let it load up and see what all shows up. You're definitely gonna wanna have the .com. And if the .com is not available for the domain you have chosen, change up the domain that you are selecting so that way you have the top level domain, because when it comes to doing SEO, that will help it with ranking. And when it comes to running ads, people will trust the .com as opposed to say .services or .store. It does not hold as much trust as .com. Once you've added it to the cart, you're gonna see some options here where they're upselling you some additional features. You can do the private email here if you would like. Basically what this is gonna do is let you have an email address at the domain. And if you're hosting with either HostGator or Bluehost, you'll be able to add these for free. Namecheap's private email, it's about $9 a year or $10 a year, something like that. It's very, very, very affordable. But what you're gonna wanna do when you do select emails, and we'll get into this later when we start building out the site, you will want to make it an email address such as sales@your domain name or contact or info or something of the like to make your site look as professional as possible. For the example of a water damage restoration contracting site, you want to basically make it look like it is a water damage restoration company that is out there working in the field, communicating with clients, and you want to model their professional image and make sure your site has that as well. So now we've moved over to the shopping cart, and it works just like buying anything online. If you're buying from Amazon or any other type of e-commerce store, the process is the exact same thing. Just click confirm order, and then you enter in the payment details, and then you are good to go. So I will see you on the other side. So once the purchase has been completed, you'll want to go to your dashboard and then go down to your domain list. So you're gonna want to go down to name servers, and right now it is sitting at the basic Namecheap DNS. And really all you need to know about name servers is that it really just points to where the site is hosted, and that's as technical as I want to get with it. The goal with the course is not to figure out a bunch of techno jargon. If there's an issue with this, either Namecheap support or the hosting company support will definitely be able to help you out with this. But first things first, what you're going to want to do is go to custom DNS. That way when we get into the cPanel of our website, we can just copy and paste and it's right here. It usually takes then about 24 hours to propagate, and then we are all set up and squared to go and good to go with our website. So now, next thing we're gonna do is go over here to HostGator, and we're gonna get hosting for our new domain. I really like HostGator because number one, their customer service has been absolutely amazing the past few years that I have used them, and their service is actually quite affordable. When you compare it to some of the other big hosting companies, you can get your first month of shared hosting for a penny. And if you decide to go with a site that'll have an SSL certificate, and this is basically a business plan, it'll only be about $7 or $8 for the first month, and then $17 or $20 for each month after that. Very, very, very affordable. There is a link to HostGator with the discount codes down below this video, as well as in the resources section. So what we're gonna do first is click get started. And for this site, we are going to use the business plan. If you want to have a positive SSL on your site, I highly recommend going with the business plan. If you're primarily going to be running call only ads where people are really not going to be visiting the site very much, then the hatchling plan will definitely suffice for that. But for this website, we're going to be using the business plan. We're gonna go back over here to Namecheap, copy our domain, and we're gonna click I already own this domain. We're gonna put our domain here, and it's gonna say that it's not available. However, what we're gonna do is I already own this domain, and then they're gonna offer a ton of upsells for other domains. We wanna skip that. Gonna do business plan, and then we're gonna go to 1 month and create a username, all that type of stuff, and basically follow the same protocol for buying stuff online. You can certainly use some of these additional services if you prefer. Otherwise, there are WordPress plugins that you can add that will do some of the same stuff that these tools do as well, with the exception of the professional email. But being as the goal is to generate calls as opposed to generate contact form submissions or emails, a professional inbox is really not needed at this time. So for when it comes to the coupon code, in order to get the deal for the just unbelievably cheap first month for your site, you want to add in 1 cent for the coupon code. And there we go, 1 cent for domain hosting for a site with an SSL certificate. Very, very, very good deal. So I'm going to complete the purchase and I'll see you on the other side. So then once everything's all completed, you're going to want to click here if you're not automatically redirected from this screen. Sometimes it takes a little bit of time. And then once it's already loaded up, you're going to want to click on packages, and you're going to go down to your site. And at the moment, this one's still pending. May take a little bit. I will check back in once this is no longer pending. So as HostGator is loading in your new domain and everything, you're gonna wanna go check your email that you used when you signed up with HostGator. They will send you some very important information that you need for your site. And it's gonna look something like this, and basically show you the credentials that you need. And it's also going to show you the name servers that you need. So what you're gonna wanna do is go down to name server 1 and name server 2, copy the first one, come back over here to Namecheap, paste name server 1 into name server 1's spot, and then name server number 2 into name server number 2, then click the green check mark, and there we go. You definitely want to save this email somewhere so that way you can get access to your cPanel, because it is a pretty important part of your website. You can either click from the email that you had got from HostGator, or you can click from here to get access to the login for your cPanel. Obviously everything's blanked out here on the screen, but basically what you want to do is click the login link. It'll bring you over to your cPanel login, and you'll want to take the credentials from your email and put them into here and then log into your cPanel. So now that we're over here at your cPanel, what you're gonna wanna do is go down to software, and you're gonna wanna click on quick install. And we're gonna be installing WordPress onto your site. You wanna click on WordPress, the free one right here. So then you're gonna wanna select your domain and then click next. And you're gonna wanna basically just fill out the name of your site. So if it's National Fire Damage 24/7, that's gonna go right here. Then select the username that you wanna use, your name, last name, and then the email address that you want to have for the admin of the site. And that's the email address that's gonna receive the credentials that you need to log into the site. Terms of service right there. And there we go. Then you will click install, and it might take a minute, but then it'll install. If there is an error though, you will want to reach out to HostGator, whichever hosting company you're using, reach out to their support. They should be able to help you out with getting it installed. Sometimes they have to go in on their end and redo things. However, being as you're paying them for their service, they're usually more than willing to help. So then once you have installed WordPress, check the email that you used for the administration email or admin email. That will have the credentials if they are not displayed on the screen right there after the installation is complete. Most of the time they should show up right there. Then what you're gonna wanna do is go to your domain name, and then you're gonna wanna do /wp-admin. And that's gonna take you to the login for your site. And what you're gonna wanna do is enter in either the email address you used or the username you selected and the password, and you log in. So from here at the dash, what you're gonna wanna do, if you did in fact get the business package and you need to install an SSL, you are probably going to want to get in touch with HostGator support right away, because that way they can install it the proper way, because if it's not installed the right way, it can be a really big pain. And for them to do it, it's a very quick and painless process. And then once it's done and it's set forever. You never have to touch it again. So what you want to do though, in order to get this established, is to go to your customer portal, click on hosting, click hosting account, get your domain, click SSL certificates, and then you'll follow through the protocol and add your domain and your name and the organization name, which you could just do your company name. You could do the name of the brand, whichever you prefer. It does not really matter at this point, whichever you prefer, but you definitely will need to get in touch with HostGator support, because they will be able to install the SSL the proper way. Then all you have to do is add the plugin called Really Simple SSL. And on HostGator's end, they will be able to add the SSL, and you will just have this running in the background. And to add Really Simple SSL, you just go to Add New and you'll type in Really Simple. And it'll be this one here by Roger Lankhorst. It's the one with the over a million active installations. You click down, or you click install now and then activate, and then it will basically be just running in the background. You do not need to touch it unless something changes with your website. But then again, reach out to HostGator support. Their staff is trained pretty well at handling these types of tasks. So a quick recap: Namecheap to get the domain, make sure it is not specific to someone else's name, and then go and grab hosting and then install WordPress onto your website. And then if you are doing an SSL certificate on your site, you will definitely want to reach out to the support team with your hosting company, and they will be able to help you set that up so that way it's done properly and there are no errors with it, because that's something you do not want to mess up, because you could end up breaking the site and not being able to get access. So I'll see you in the next video.